Sunday afternoon and cherry blossom season. A 1 kilometre walk down this road to the castle ruins. The first time we came here, a couple of months ago, a troop of wild monkeys clambered over house roofs and along electric cables. Yes, people actually live in these tiny shacks. A small park at the entrance where we ate our late lunch. In fact, the castle was completely destroyed in 1590, and there's not much remaining. When the castle fell, the women and children threw themselves into this presently dry waterfall, ending their own lives. According to legend, the waters ran red for 3 days. Their ghosts forever haunt the place. This is the location of the palace. The main castle buildings are higher up the mountain. just behind and below our campsite. And this is the mountain summit, with no visible remains of any castle buildings. You can, however, sometimes see the shadows of ghosts when the light falls just so. She does things like this. We had heavy rain during the night and woke up in the clouds. Some shelter for breakfast, because it's not just wet, but much colder than we were expecting. The nearest thing to ghosts that this mountain displayed. A fortuitous find. Next time we camp here, we don't need to bring our own water. The hiking signpost is very vague, and we have no idea where we are going or how far it might be. Thank you. The stones are part of the castle complex. We've actually reached the place named on the signpost. It's just another summit with a picnic table. Upward and onward, though now a new sign tells us we're heading towards the popular Mount Takao. We've almost arrived and suddenly find ourselves beside this giant pay road. Back to civilization. And so we arrive at Takao. It's 3:15 and about 4 hours since we set off. And time for a beer. Or two.